The next algorithm that we are going to be working with is the trade first method. And the trade first method is a lot like the traditional method, except instead of borrowing and subtracting and then continuing with the borrowing process and subtracting, we are going to get all of our borrowing done first, and then we are going to do the subtracting at the end. So let's see what I'm talking about. So to understand the trade first method, we're going to first look at the ones column. And when we look at the ones column, like the traditional method, we're looking to see if this bottom number is bigger than this top number. And in this problem, it is. We have a 4 at the bottom and a 3 at the top. So in order to subtract, we're going to need to go next door, and we're going to make this a 3. And then we're going to bring that 1 over in front of the 3 to have 13. Now with the traditional method, we would usually stop right now and subtract 13 from 4. But with the trade first method, we're going to continue in making sure we can actually start subtracting without having to do any more borrowing. But what we find out when we look in the tens column is we have a 5 at the bottom and a 3 at the top. So we're still going to need to borrow. So we're going to borrow 1 from this 9. And we're going to have an 8, and then we're going to bring that 1 over in front of the 3, so we'll have a 13. And now we have 8 take away 6 in the hundreds column, which we can do. So now we're going to go all the way back to the ones column and do all of our subtracting. So we have 13 take away 4, which is 9. And we have 13 take away 5, which is 8. And then we have 8 take away 6, which is 2. And we end up with the answer of 289. This next problem we are also going to solve using the trade first method. So we are going to start with the ones column, and we are going to look at the bottom number to see if it is bigger than the top number. And in this situation, it is. So in order to subtract, we are going to need to move next door to the tens column. We're going to borrow 1 from this 1, and it will become a 0. And this 1 will become an 11. And then remember, since we're doing the trade first method, we are not going to start subtracting now. We are going to keep looking at the problem to see if we need to borrow any more. So we're going to look at the tens column. The 3 is bigger than the 0. So we are going to need to borrow from this 1. We're going to cross it off, make it a 0. We're going to take that 1 that we borrowed, and we're going to move it over here next to this 0. So now we have 10. And now let's look at the hundreds column. The 3 is bigger than the 0, so we are going to need to borrow from this 3, make it a 2, and then move that 1 over in front of the 0 to have another 10. So now we can subtract 2 from 2, so now we're going to go ahead and subtract this problem. So we're starting back at the ones column. We have 11 take away 2, which is 9. And then in the tens column, we have 10 take away 3, which is 7. And in the hundreds column, we have 10 take away 3, which is also 7. And we have 2 take away 2, which is 0. And remember, we do not need to put a 0 if it is the first number in the answer. So that is how you use the trade first method.